One can spend a small fortune filling their kitchen with kitchen gadgets to add variety to their meals. The sous vide cooker has become a pretty popular kitchen gadget over the last several years, but many feel intimidated by this very simple device. The sole function of a sous vide cooker is to keep a container of water at a constant temperature for a specific period of time. In this video, I want to show you how easy it is to sous vide, and despite your reservations, you can do it too. Sous vide translates to under vacuum, but currently using the phrase generally refers to immersion cooking in a precisely controlled water bath. USDA recommendations generally refer to what the internal temperature of the meat has to reach, but don't directly address sous vide styles of cooking, where the meat is held at a specific temperature for a much longer period of time. With a sous vide cooker, you maintain a lower temperature for a much longer period of time while maintaining the food in a bag, which holds in any juices that may have otherwise evaporated right next to the cut of meat that you are cooking. This not only prevents drying out, but also infuses the food with additional flavor. In this video, I'm using the Anova Nano Precision Sous Vide Cooker. I bought it about 6 months ago and have mainly made steak and pork with it. And I can say that each time I used it, the meat came out perfectly cooked. Tonight, we're going to be making pork. The idea is to get as much of the air out as possible to allow for as close as possible contact of the water with the cut of meat inside the bag, and any air will prevent this from happening. I usually fill the pot with hot water from the faucet to give the sous vide a head start. The Anova Nano is a 750-watt immersion cooker, and there are definitely more powerful ones out there that would heat up the water much faster. However, for a small household, this is plenty. All you do next is attach the cooker to the pot and plug it in. Make sure your Bluetooth is on. Once set up, the app automatically connects to the cooker, and you can start the cooking process. Once the desired amount of time is done, the food is ready to take out of the pot. Before we move on, don't forget to like and subscribe. Alright, let's go. I dry off the cut of meat with some paper towels after taking it out of the bag. In this case, I finalized the cooking process by searing the pork on a skillet for about 2 minutes on each side. Following this, it's ready to serve. Many of the recipes on the Anova app have instructions on how to make a sauce by using the remaining liquid from the Ziploc bag. In addition, the app has recipes for different types of meats, including beef, poultry, fish, lamb, and others. I hope you found this video helpful, and I hope you join me on the next one.